In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create this stone glass wall blend. It looks really cool. It's popular when you reconstruct these really old houses and then you want to keep the stone wall, but you also want to open up the house a little bit. I think it looks amazing. So why not try to do this in Revit? And yes, it's possible and it gives a really cool result. So let's do it. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of content dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Also, there you can find some other useful Revit content, such as templates, families, and plugins. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. I have these simple four walls, and this is what we're going to be using for this demonstration. As you can see, I have applied a stone material to these walls. So if I select the wall, go into edit type, go into structure, it only has one material applied, and it's this kind of old stone wall. This is what that looks like. So this is what I have applied. Now I'm just going to click OK, and then OK again, and OK again. And now it's time to carve out this wall. Now, before we get started with that, one important warning, and that is to make sure that there are going to be no more changes to these walls and also to the material map. So if you change the size of the walls, or if you change the scale, or the position of the material map, then you're going to have to do this process all over again. So make sure that everything is in order and then you can get started. So basically, we just want to carve out this wall to follow these actual stones. Now we can do this simply by selecting the wall and then going into edit profile. However, this does give us an issue, because when you go into edit profile, it basically reduces the wall to these magenta lines, or the outline or the profile of the wall, and we no longer see the material map. So what we need to do is escape out of here, and then you can either use the model lines, or you can go into one of the elevation views like this, and then here you can use the detail lines, and then basically what you can do is sketch out where that line of the wall will be, and then use that and use pick lines to do the actual edit profile. So let me show you how that works. I'm going to be doing this in 3D, and we're going to be using model lines for that. Now, before we click on model line, make sure to go here to set work plane. I'm going to use pick a plane option and then hover over the exterior face of this wall, just like this, and then go to model line. Li is the shortcut. And then basically you can zoom in just like this. You can even use this view cube to gonna turn that into an elevation view, and then you can just get started. So I can start from here, go like that. Okay, so go around this stone, then go up to here, then go something like this, and basically you can carve out this however you like it to go. Now I'm just going to hit the escape key a couple of times, and I'm actually going to select this and delete it, because I have already done this and I have it here hidden. So if I go to reveal hidden elements, here you can see I have these two very complex model lines, which we're going to be using for that outline. I have already sketched this out. So what I'm going to do is just select one of them, select the other one, hold the control key to add to selection. So let's make sure we select all of them, just like this. And then we go to unhide element, just like that. And then go escape the reveal hidden elements. So now we have those detail lines in place. Now, when I select the wall and go into edit profile, and let me just switch this back to hidden line, just makes it a bit simpler. Okay, there we go. Now I can simply use pick lines, and then I can hover over these and pick those. Now I want to select the entire chain. So let's hover over one of them, hit the tab key, and sometimes it's going to just select a few. So what you need to do is you need to kind of go around and try hitting the tab key on all of them. And at some point, it is going to select the entire chain of lines. See, here we have it a little bit bigger. but still not all of them. It's actually quite annoying that Revit does this, but yeah, this is something that we have to deal with. So you kind of want to try to figure out one that's going to work for the entire chain of lines. So these are connected, but still gives us issues sometimes. Okay, here we go. I think I have found one. So let me click. There we go. Selects everything. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and then I'm just going to use the trim and extend to corner and fix this up, and then do the same up here, just like that. Hit the escape key a couple of times, select this line here, hit delete, and then just hit finish. And now if we turn back realistic on, you can see it's actually following the contour of these stones. So the edge of the wall is following the contour of those stones, and it looks amazing. So now we just want to repeat that on the other side. So select this wall, go into edit profile. Let's go back to hidden line, use the pick lines, and now use the tab key and try to find the magic line that's going to select the entire chain. So I've managed to select it all. I had to do it in parts in this case, but yeah, I think everything is connected. Perhaps here we may have a gap, so yeah, I have to do this one manually. So it is a little bit annoying, this behavior in Revit, but that's okay. Here we have this one missing as well. Yeah, we have a few. Let's see, where is this one? Okay, so it's that one. Okay, there we go. So once we have done this, now we can just go to trim and extend to corner, fix this up here, and then fix it up here as well. Hit the escape key a couple of times, select this line, hit delete, hit finish, and there we go. Now, when we go back into realistic, again, as we zoom in, you're going to see, let me turn off the thin lines. Yeah, you're going to see that that edge actually follows the contour of the stones themselves, and it looks pretty amazing. Now, to complete this, because you don't want to be left with a huge hole in your house, let's go down into level one, just like this, zoom in a little bit, and then let's go to wall, and I'm just going to pick out the storefront two curtain wall. This is just one that they have created for this. And then let's just place it like this, hit the space key to flip it to the other side. Let's go up to there, perfect. And now I'm just going to go to the move tool. So let's select this, go to the move tool, MV is the shortcut. Select the edge here and move it towards the wall perpendicularly like that. Repeat the same process here. So just move that edge to the wall, perfect. Then let's go to the 3D view, see what that looks like. So here we seem to have a couple of these mullions close together. So I think if I go back into level one and move this in ever so slightly, it should get rid of that additional mullion. So let's see. Yeah, I think that did the trick. Everything looks to be in order. And then finally, I just want to create a corner here. So let's hit the tab key a few times until we select a corner mullion, right click off to the side, and then go to select mullions on grid line, just like this. And then we're just going to be unpinning all of them. And then here in the properties panel, let's go with a, let's go with the L mullion, something like this, delete elements, and there we go. So now we have this L mullion. It looks good in the corner. We should definitely reduce the height of these, just like that. And there we go. So now we have this really cool kind of stone glass wall that you can use for perhaps reconstruction of an old Italian villa. So there we go. It's possible to do something like this in Revit. Now, if you want to get access to this Revit project file, either to just test it out on your own or use it in your own projects, you can find all of my Revit project files, over 500 files, on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above, and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.